Good morning. What about others? Still they're sleeping or what? Srinidhi,
yes sir.
Ushalagidiya?
Ha sir.
Okay. We'll see on 8:35 I'll start. Anyway, you are not traveling. You are at home only. At least 8:30 you should log in now. Right. Anyway, we'll start the class. Let them join. So yesterday we had discussed about the simple property, indexed property, bounded property, and constrained the properties. Four things we had discussed, and continuation of the Java Beans today, we'll discuss about the persistence. So persistence is nothing but it is a Java beans. I have the ability to save the beans, to store and retrieve it at the later time. So once you do the any programming, any changes, whatever you are doing, whatever the settings you have made it changes, all these things will be saved here. So later stages, you can retrieve the data, or you can see the settings and you can execute the programs. That is what the first point says. The second one is the configuration settings are saved. Once you change any modifications, it will be saved automatically. That is what the configuration settings are saved. The next one is nothing but the, it is implemented by Java serialization that already we had discussed last class itself. So this is nothing but the serial. Whatever we are doing in Java fields will go one by one only. The next one is, if the beans inherits directly or indirectly from component class, it is automatically serializable. So even you are inheriting the programs either directly or indirectly, or importing the programs, whatever it may be, it will work serially. Transistent keyword can be used to designate the data members and not to be saved. Example, thread reference the numbers. Thread reference numbers will not be saved here. So time being, whatever you are creating the threads or creating the chains will be executed at the moment, then it will close that one. That it will not be saved for the reference purpose later stages. That is what the persistence here. So persistence is nothing but briefly we can say whatever we are doing, changes will be saved, options will be working here, and we can retrieve the data later stages. And the next one is configuration settings. Whatever you are doing, it will be saved. Once you do any setting changes, automatically it will be saved, that one. That means you have to click the save button. So no need to change every time. So once you do saving, changes made it and click the save, so it will be saved, that one. So this is one, it will be working the serialization. And Java beans either inherits directly or indirectly, whatever it may be. So from the component class, it is automatically serializable. So whatever you are inheriting doesn't matter, it will work serially only this one. So keyword can be designated the data members, not be saved. Example, only few of the method, few of the chains, threads will not be saved for the future reference purpose. Whenever it is required, you are creating the child, that it will be executed, that reference numbers will not be saved. That's all. Remaining everything will be saved and it will be working serially. That is what the persistence in the inconsistence properties. Next is the customizers. Customizers is nothing but property sheet may not be the best user interface for the complex component. So complex component, this sometimes may not be the best user interface. So we have to remember many methods, many packages, all these things. So sometimes interfaces, sometimes some cases may not be suitable for the GUI purpose. So it can provide the step-by-step wizards guides to the components. So here is no problem, step-by-step process we can execute it. So it can provide the GUI with images. So this already we had discussed, AWT. And this one will be working GUI frame with the images, which visually tells what is changed, such as radio button, checking button, and so on, menu buttons, menu items, all these things. GUI, we can use it using the Java beans. So it can customize the appearance and behavior of the properties. So it appears behavior of the properties. That means whatever you are creating, like radio button, menu items, and so on, that behaviors will be displaying the properties. So properties, we can see it. That is what the customizers. So this is nothing but the, some of the cases interfaces bit difficult, that doesn't matter, no problem. So whenever you are using the GUI interfacing between one to another one, some cases we are getting the problems, that we'll see it when we are executing the programs. So step by step process is there, we can understand easily, we can execute the programs easily. So GUI provides here like a radio button, check buttons, menu items, top up bar, or top down, all these things we can use it here. And here is the it will be appear the properties of the behaviors, that is what the customizers. Next we have the design pattern for the user defined events. So we have the design properties for the user defined events. So here we have the two methods. So let us see what are the two methods will be working. So beans can generate events and send them to the objects in delegation events models. So sometimes, sorry for the interrupted, sometimes I'm getting cough, that is the reason you'll be getting the break. Okay, so here is beans can can generate the events and send them to the other objects in delegation events model. That is what the first one. Second one is called the listener registration and unregistration. That methods, let us see here, public void add t listener and the object name. And the second one is nothing but the public void remove t listener, removing registration and unregistration. That is nothing but the remove t listener the object name. That is what the two methods we have to remember here. One is called the public void add t listener, and t listener and the object. So this is what the syntax for the first one. And the second one is called the public void remove t listener of the x object name. So that is what the two methods we need to create it. So one method is called the add t listener. That is what the first one. So this one is nothing but the, it generates the events and send them to the object delegation event model. That is what the first one. And the second one is called the either registration or unregistration. So can be done using the remove t listener of the x. Now user defined listener events. Let us see the user defined user t listeners. One small example, let us see here, simple one. So the first one is called the time class will fire off timeout event. So time class fire off and time off events. So the first one is how to write it is nothing but the public. We have to give the interface between the time class and timeout event. So time listener extends events listener. So these two things we have to use it. Events extends is nothing but the event listener. So public class interfaces we are using here. So public void timeout. So timeout event e dot time. So we can use all the time options in this. So public class time events extends the event objects. That means what here you can make the set default timings. So this one will be live, maybe 5 seconds or 10 seconds or 20 seconds or 1 minute, whatever it may be, we can give the timings a life of the that particular methods. That is what the meaning here. And let us see how it will be working. So public class time event extends the event objects. This we have to write it. These are all the methods we need to remember here. So public time event, public object, super dot object. So we are creating the super of the object, whatever we, whenever you are calling that particular method. So that one only, that is the reason this dot we are using also. So public int get count, return the count. So we need to return the count. Another one is called the public void set count, integer count. So this dot count is equal to count. So whatever you are returning the count for that particular object, that one only will be returning. That is what the use for the, this dot count is equal to count. So this is what the simple user defined listener and the event of the programs. Next one is called the time class fires off and timeout event, all the registration of the objects. So how to write the objects? Let us see here continuation of the particular programs. So public void start timer. So timer will be starting before calling the functions. When we did the lab programs ada, so before calling the function we are calling the time function. That means system time will be taken. So after execution again we are taking the system time, and the difference of the time we have calculated with the nanoseconds. Now here also the same thing, because when how many seconds or how many minutes should live that particular method. So that is the reason public void start timer. So if t is equal to null, so time if it is not taking, that is what that one. Another one is called the t is equal to new thread of this. So there is no time, we have to state the take the time t is equal to new thread of this, that is equal to t dot start. So it will start the taking the time for the particular method. That is what the first one. Next is public void run. So you know that applets, whenever you are having init the methods, run the programs, all these things will be there. Here also the same way it will be working. Public void run, so for semicolon semicolon, how many methods are there? Let it execute it infinitely. So try t dot sleep time out. So we have to t dot time sleep. So after some time we have to sleep that one. So when it is executing, so we'll go, we have to wait it. So then we have to sleep for the time out of that one. Catch exception e, so fire off. So that means, so we are closing the particular method. So during that time, maybe due to internet problems or requesting problem or sending problem, whatever it may be. So after some time, you can stop it the way of working that one, maybe timeout. So for example, best example, we can see internet banking. Maybe if you are not refreshing 1 or 2 minutes, like SBI, if you take, what will happen? Expires the session, you can re-log in. So the similarly you can write it here, the code also, or it will work the same way here also. That is what the fire off, that one. Now we have to write the function for the fire off. So let us write it here, void fire off timer event object name is equal to new timer event of that this. So particular that function only, the particular method only. So object name TE, TE dot set count of the number. So fire off is nothing but, so counting that numbers. So that is called the, maybe once you put the nanoseconds of the 5000 or 1 lakh or whatever it may be, it will be counting for that. Till that time only will be alive the particular method. So lifelong cannot be alive that one. You know that, because many people are requesting through online. So that is the reason, whatever it may be the reason, if it is working with the specific duration, let it go ahead. Otherwise it will stop that one. Otherwise what will happen, many users are requesting, it will stuck that one. So because due to some problems, if it is stuck that one, if it is not delivered the particular messages, so it will stuck that one, it entire operations will be stopped down. That is the reason here we are taking te dot set count of the numbers. So vectors, we are taking the listeners and vector listener dot clone. So this is nothing but, the vector is nothing but entire the requests will be stored into the vectors like arrays, so that it will be working one by one, one by one. If it is not working that one, if it is timeout, it will go for the next one. So int l is equal to 0, listener that one we have taken, L is less than listener of the size I plus plus. That means one by one will be executing after that one. That is what the timer dot listener. We have taken the time dot listener. So listener dot element at L. So whatever your, which object we are taking that one, dot timeout of TE. Timeout of TE is nothing but the, we have taken for the fire of that one. That means this numbers will be exceeding the whatever you are given the limits, then it will go out of that one. Otherwise, it will execute that one. If it is executing, no problem. If it is not executing, that live will be die after some count. That is what the function for the user-defined listener event. Next, this is what the brief already I have told you, but let us discuss once again here. Create the new beans. First, what we have to do it already yesterday also we have told you, but still once again I have wrote it here. Create a directory for the new beans. We have to create the new beans and create the Java source files. So you need to create the Java source files where you are getting that one and copy it here and compile the source files. So whatever you have typed that one source file, Java beans file, you can compile that one. So once you compile that one, automatically we have to create the main faced files. That is called the way of, see here, beans.java, like this it will be created, and main faced is nothing but it will be created MFT with the extension. And next, once you do this, it will be generating the jar files. Next, start the BDK. Next, test the programs. So this is what the creating the new beans to follow the steps. So I'll try to execute one class, this one, how it will be installing and how to execute the one or two programs. I'll tell you. So this is all the steps to be followed. We have to create the directory and create the Java source files and compile the source files. Next is called the create the main paste files and generate the jar files and start BDK and test the programs. So example programs, simple programs like set size for the one size programs we have done, that is called the 200 200, starting this one with the rectangular box. Let us see that one how it will be working. Packages sunw.demo.colors. So we are creating the package, this one packages already you know that, later we can be reusable, otherwise you can make the comment this and you can write it from the next one. So already we had discussed, this is also extension of the AWT. So import java.awt.star, all the packages, even AWT we are downloading. Importing java.awt.event. Public class, colors extends the canvas programs. That is where the your file name is called the colors. So public class and file name is called colors, extends the canvas. So once you do this, next is transistent private color, and the color is the object, and private boolean rectangular. We are creating the rectangular, that's what I told you already. So now public colors, now add mouse listener. So mouse, cursor, all these things we can execute at GUI. So that is what the many options are available. So public void mouse. First one is called the add mouse listener, new mouse adapter. So when you are moving this, clicking that one, that is what option should work. Next is called the public void mouse pressed. So whenever you are clicking the pressed, so mouse event ME, that is called the changed. So what changes to be done? So for example, some of the objects are there. When you are clicking that one, maybe that behavior should be displayed. For example, I want to purchase the laptop. Whenever I'm clicking that behavior, that property should be displayed. So that is what the way of changes. So you want to buy some of the vegetables online or some of the dresses. So once you, all the items will be displayed. So suppose if you are liking one of that one, if you are clicking that properties will be displayed there in detail. Maybe they are giving warranty or discount or concession. So where it is coming from, all the details will be coming. That is what the mouse event changes. So rectangular is equal to false. First one rectangular will be false. Set size is equal to 200 comma 100. So 200 100 rectangular will be displaying. Another one is called the changes. What changes to be done for after clicking that, after mouse click, something to be changes. So that is what the some of the small program for the colors. So get size 200 200. So I want to change the colors after clicking that mouse. So that is what will be happening. So next is public boolean get the rectangular. So once you get the rectangular, return the rectangular box. So public void, set the rectangular boolean flag. This dot rectangular is equal to flag. So whatever you are, so once you click that, it will be reflected to the new one. Again clicking that, again going, coming back to that one. So that is what the, again setting the flags, sometimes 1, 0, and 1. So that is what the repaint that. So again, once again do the repaint. So that is what the one example program for the Java beans. So creating the rectangular box and say filling the some of the colors and using the mouse listener, changing the activities. That is what the program says. This is what the example. Any doubt, if you have, please tell me. So this is what the sun w.demo.colors import java.awt. So import java.awt.event. So this is what the way of working. So now we'll move to the next one. Example, another programs. So here is nothing but what will happen, public void changes. So colors is equal to random.color. So whenever you are mouse clicking, so some of the things to be changes, how it will be happening. One second, Sari is asking some message. I'll send one message and I'll come back to you. Right, so continuation is nothing but the repaint is nothing but these are all the colors they have taken. So one is red, blue, green, blue. So this is what they will be changing. So whenever you are clicking colors, one color should be changed. So color is equal to random.color repaint. So that how it will be working for the repaint is nothing but color, random color is nothing but whatever, whenever you are calling this function random, so it will be assigned to this one. We'll be calling here. So it will, whenever you are pressing red, so int 250 into math.random numbers will be taken. And green, same thing will be taken for that one. Blue also will be taken the same thing. Return new color RGB. So one time will be changing for that. That is what the example one for the program for this. Way of working. This is what the packages for the AWT extension of the Java business. Right. This is what the program. Any doubt if you are having, you can ask me. So only the program is nothing but one. Whenever you are clicking, the mouse clicking should be changed. That's what the example I told you. Whenever you want to purchase some of the things, for example, laptop. Many laptops will be displayed. So if you are selecting one, that configurations, all these things should be seen in that. We have to check it out, how to check it out, all those things. So once you click that, it will be move that one. Again, you can come back or you can proceed to buy that one. That is what the options. So here what we did is nothing but selecting one rectangular box and whenever clicking that, color should be changing, keep on. So that is what the programs we have taken, the random numbers for the 255 0 to 255 colors will be there, math that random numbers. so will be taken. So based on that one, will be changed to red, green, all these things. So next is public void graph G, dimension D is equal to get size. So for that, H is equal to D dot height, W is equal to D dot width, G dot set color is equal to color, whatever you are setting the colors. If rectangular, G dot get fill of rectangular 0 to 0, whatever you have created the starting location with the how much width is there, how much height is there, 0 to n minus 1, like that one will be filling. Else G dot fill overall 0 comma 0, W minus 1 and H minus 1. If it is not rectangular, any other way also is the oval also, fill the oval 0 to width and height. So two diagrams we have taken, rectangular and this one, both should be filled. So this is where the programs will be working. So next one is called the keep Java source in the appropriate package and compile. So C, beans demo sun demo colors. So these are the example programs will be created. So now how to do it? Create the main paste file is nothing but C beans demo in the directory. So here we have to create the continuous this one. So sun w slash demo colors colors dot class. So Java beans true, generate a jar files. So how to generate the jar files is nothing but if you are in C directory slash bin slash demo, then the following example. So we have to write this. This is the way of writing the example. Jar confirm this one dash dash slash jar colors dot setting the path. So this is the way of setting the path. Then you can type the star the BDK and test. So you can test with the existing other buttons, means for other handling, for change the methods. So this is more the way of installing the Java beans and try to use it this. So deployment of the beans. All Java classes can be converted to a beans. All Java classes we can convert into the Java beans deployment. So we can deploy the all Java classes can be converted to the beans. Whatever we did it for the Java class, we can convert into this one. Bean is compressed and saved in the format of jar files, which contains main feast files, class files, zip files, and other information customization of the files. So these are all the compress and we can save it, because when you are having the bigger one, we can compress it. So sun netbeans, you have BDK, visual cave, JBuilder, visual edge, or the beans builder tools. So these are all the different tools are available. So we can use any one of this and we can try to execute the Java beans programs. So we have sun netbeans, you have BDK is there, visual cave is there, JBuilder is there, visual edge is there, or the beans builder tools. These are all the builder tools, and we can use any one of these tools and we can execute the programs. So next is, once you selected any one of that, next we have to go for the Java jar files. So jar file allows you to efficient deploy a set of the class and their associated resources. Jar file allows you to efficient deploy a set of classes and their associated the resources. So jar file makes it much easier to deliver the install and download, and it is compressed. So jar files, it is easy for us to deliver installation and download and compression also. This it is easy for the Java files. Once first step is installation, next is called the jar files. Next is main feast is nothing but we have to do this one, main feast.temp name is equal to sample beans.class and Java beans is equal to true. So main paste file we have to do like this. And creating and extracting the jar files. creating the jar files is nothing but jar. We have to how to create the jar files is nothing but jar cfm and sample beans dot jar and main phase tmp and start dot all the classes. So in this case, what will happen? Creating the jar files. So once you extracting the files from the jar files, jar xf simple beans dot jar files. So compressing is nothing but extracting the files is nothing but jar files is nothing but from xf to this one is this is what. So creating the jar files is nothing but this one. So this to this or this. So either tmp file or class file you can create it using the jar. And when you are extracting, you have to write like these files. So here is called the summary of the Java Beans. Java Beans is a platform, neutral component architecture for the reusable software component. So reusable software component for the Java platforms. It is a black box component to be used to build the large component or applications. Next one is called the property methods, events, instance vector, customizer are parts of the Java Beans interface. This is not the summary of the this one. So this is what the Java Beans. So Java Beans is nothing but we have to practice the program, some of the programs. So first we need to install any one package, that one. Next we have to create the main phase files and jar files. Once you do this, we can execute the program. So here is nothing but like a menu bar, menu items, so images, so creating the boxes like AWT, whatever we did it, and extension of that one, and easily we can implement it using the Java Beans. So that is what we can do it. So we have to practice some of the programs using this one, and this is what the theory for the Java Beans. So any doubts if you are having, you can ask me for the Java Beans. So normally that four properties are important, that is called the simple, indexed, bounded, constraints. So that is what they will be happening. Let us see one question paper how it will be how they have asked the second unit and third unit. Right. Can you able to see the question paper? Hello?
Yes,
yes. So here we have the JSP only. Explain the JSP at Java Pages attributes and explain the JSP predefined variables. These two things we did it in JSP only, Java Server Pages at Pages and predefined. So once you define that, how it will be working, you can check it out, the PPTs, and these two things will be happening. And Java Beans, it is not available in this one. And here they have asked JSP program which uses the forward and JSP include action tags. So forward pages also we have did it this one. This is what that one, maybe that syllabus bit different is there. And let us see here what they have asked. And what is the need for the JSP benefits, advantages, JSP over competing technologies. That is what you have to write it. What, why we are using the JSP, Java Server Pages, and what type of programs we are doing. What is advantages compared to previous servlet cycles, we have to write it. And competing the technologies we have to write. Next is explain the different types of the JSP tags with an example for each. Different tags, file forward, attributes, hash, all these things we have to write it for the JSP programs. Next here is list of all the attribute space directives tags. Explain any five examples for the each. Next is write a JSP program which displays an applet with the help of the JSP plugin tag. So plugin page we have to create for the Java server pages tagging using this. So that is what this one here they ask to see here. What is a Java Beans? What are the key concepts of the Java Beans? List out the advantages and Java Beans. Next is, what are all the different categories of the JDBC drivers? And what are the basic steps need to be followed while writing the applications of the JDBC? That's all. Only one question they have asked in this, but because the question paper pattern is different. Now our third unit is nothing but entire one unit is called Java Beans. So here, if they asked two questions, they're supposed to ask 10, 10, 20, 10, 10, 20. So four questions they're supposed to ask. So that is the reason we have to read entire thing. What is Java? What is the Java Beans? How to install that one? How to write the some of the programs, example programs. Two to three example programs they have given. Like that one only, the similar fashion only they will be asking the programs. And we'll see if it is getting the 17 MCA or 18 MCA question paper. I don't have that one. That is the problem. I'll check it out in the library. If it is available, we'll download and we'll see it. Okay. So simple questions only. See, now you can see the question papers, how they were asked. That is what the second unit and third unit. So now from tomorrow, we'll go for the next chapter, fourth chapter. So JDBC connection, that is most important, that we'll see it. Shall we stop the class now? I'll take the attendance, then we'll stop. Tell me, answer your attendance. One.
Present, sir.
Two.
Present, sir.
Three.
Present, sir.
Four.
Yes, sir.
Five.
Present, sir.
Six. Seven.
Present, sir.
Eight.
Sir.
Nine.
Present, sir.
Eight.
Eight present, sir.
Oh, okay. 10.
Present, sir.
11.
Present, sir.
12.
Present, sir.
13. 14.
Present, sir.
16.
Present, sir.
17.
Present, sir.
18.
Present, sir.
19.
Present, sir.
20. 21.
Present, sir.
22.
Present, sir.
23.
Present, sir.
24.
Present, sir.
25.
Yes, sir.
26.
Present, sir.
27.
Yes, sir.
28.
Sir, 20 present, sir.
20 present, huh? Okay. So where I stop? 26.
Present, sir.
27.
Yes, sir.
28. 29. 30.
Present, sir.
Series 2.
Present, sir.
3.
Present, sir.
4.
Present, sir.
5.
5 present, sir.
6. 6, 7,
present, sir.
8,
present, sir.
9,
present, sir.
10,
present, sir.
11, 12,
present, sir.
13,
present, sir.
14?
Yes, sir.
15? Sixteen.
Present, sir.
17?
Yes, sir.
16? Absent. 18?
Present, sir.
19?
Present, sir.
20?
Present, sir.
21?
Present, sir.
22?
Present, sir.
23?
Present, sir.
Right. Absentees are 6, 13, 28, 29, TD series 6, 11, and 16. Right. So, any doubt, the second unit, third unit, if you have any doubt, you can find out. So, once it is locked down, closed, second test will be conducted. After 1 week, again, third test will be conducted. I hope Ganesh sir might have told you. So this is what the procedure to conduct the test. So stay at home. Don't move anywhere. If it is necessary, then only go out. So otherwise, stay at home only. So take care of your health. Okay, shall we stop now? Right.